Hello and welcome once more to Let's Play Psychonauts. No, not that button. Last time we did both the Lungfishopolis and the Milkman Conspiracy, so today we are going to go on, and as promised, the first world that I'll be doing is Black Velvetopia, the world of Edgar Tegley's mind. Oops.
I'm surprised Milka's brain doesn't go invisible when I get close to it.
Good person.
This is
Milka's
the worst.
Brain.
I hate this stupid game.
Which last time kept the crows refusing to go down when I was trying to get it up, so... Thank you for being right there this time, crows. So as I said last time, I picked Edgar
the
to go
sun
first.
Is bright. The enemy is weak.
Because he's the one who is... He's the one who is most likely to be difficult for me when I'm trying to talk and pay attention if anybody's in the chat and play at the same time. He's the mole that is in his brain that you will shortly see will keep knocking you back if you're not paying attention to what you're doing, and when I'm doing all that at once, I am not paying the best attention to what I am doing. Oops, sorry. Let's do this the right way this time. If I can actually get on the tightrope. Or not. Hello again, Edgar.
Hey, how's that painting of Dr. Lobato coming along? You know, I'll deliver it for you as soon as it's finished.
Silence! I am conceptualizing.
What is this? Are you working on an abstract piece? Nice use of color.
That's an impressive house of cards you're building there.
And still, not high enough to reach the sky and free her from her prison.
Who is she?
I only know that she is beautiful, perfect, and sad. All day she cries rose petal tears, and I can do nothing to help her because my creation lacks something, and it will not stand against the bull.
What bull?
Audio. Somewhere along the way, I feel that I lost something important, but I do not know.
I think it's your queens. You want me to go look for them?
Bring me any cards you find. I must complete this tower.
Yes.
Are you all right? Poor little guy. Little nick on the frame. Maybe I can cover that up with a price tag or something.
So this level, while it's not my favorite to play, it is probably my very favorite looks-wise. It's so pretty, all the bright colors. I can't really see this guy that well down there, but... dude. I also just realized that actually wasn't the best first choice of a level unless I was going to go grab some more money first, because you need to buy stuff in this level. And I have 72 arrowheads total. But the first one at least is free.
Hey! Have you seen any really big playing cards around here?
Now that takes me back. Poker night with the guys. Man, I miss those dogs.
Uh-huh. So the cards, you know where they are?
Oh, right. Well, I do know about these four lost queens, but that's all. Can't do much with four queens, can you?
Those are exactly the cards I need. Where are they?
Forget about it. They're guarded by some pretty nasty characters. Not to mention El Odio. You're better off just hanging out here and turning your head just a teensy bit to the left.
I think I hate that bull a lot.
Oh, trust me. You'll hate him even more as time goes by. When he first trapped me in this alley, I thought he was only mildly annoying.
Trapped? Are you a prisoner of art just like Edgar?
I'm a prisoner of that stupid bull. I don't want to get gored, so I hide out in the alley like a low-down dog.
Okay, promise me you won't take this the wrong way. But you are a dog.
Yeah, but I'm a sacred dog, man. I should be up in the highlands above the tree line, take a brandy around my friggin' neck, seeing the world, and finding more things to paint than this junk. Which is all for sale, by the way.
Unfortunately for our poor St. Bernard friend, as he's a figment of somebody's imagination, he is never going to get into the Highlands. Unless, of course, Edgar starts daydreaming about him.
Hey, how do you get out of this alley?
We're trapped in here, son. Art is our only escape.
Is that like a metaphor, or do you mean that if I take one of these paintings, I can use it to get out of here?
If you take one of these paintings, I'll bite you on the leg. If you buy one, it could help you get out of here. They're magic.
Okay, I'm off.
Well, see ya. Keep off the street now.
Yep, you'll run into a few artist dogs in here, and they will all start painting by Raz when they meet him. In his nifty Black Velvetopia clothing. Kind of looks like a fancied-up outfit from Tron. This is the one we actually need, which is lucky.
Here's one of my newest acquisitions. Perfect condition. Yep. Okay, yes, there is a small nick on the frame, okay. It's an antique. What do you want from me? Art isn't about perfection, you know. I marked it down already. At that price, you really need to let yourself be charmed by its flaws.
I don't think I can swing these downtown gallery prices.
Enjoy your new art there.
Yeah, I don't want this painting anymore.
Sorry, buddy. All sales are final. Enjoy your new art there.
The rose you never need, but
well,
it'll
see ya.
Let you do something that can help you out later. Right now it's just going to be something cute. First of all, you can try and give it to everybody.
Touching, but I'm not interested.
But as for the one we actually need right now.
Nice! Now I can get Edgar's cards!
So anytime you see a hook on the wall, you can hang up any paintings that you have on it, and they'll do different things. Some of them are needed to open up paths to other parts of the area. Some of them just get you things if you toss them up. And the entire time you're going around, Elodio is doing his best to whack you back to earlier areas. I And the rose is actually for these ladies who are totally freaked out by you, but since I do not have much funds in this level, I'm gonna hold off showing off her until I have shown off some of the other folks around here. But you notice that she doesn't...
I'm not getting
you.
I must be out of range or something.
You are now Prince Charming with a rose if you hold it in front of her. Well, if you do not have it, you are some creepo in a trench coat. That lady is very, very easily charmed. Or very, very easily freaked out by
I need
men,
a steamer trunk tag for this guy.
Oh, come on. That was bad aim. Yeah, so this level is all about staying off the main street, except for tiny bits at a time when you're able to jump between stuff. There are lots and lots of ledges around that you can jump on, lots of places where you can swing between bars and things like that. Then you just go from alley to alley, unlocking different things without getting yourself smacked way, way back to the start of the level. Oh, and there is the first bouncer sensor. That is not what I was trying to do. I forgot that I don't have my gun out. Yeah, those are the big thugs of the sensor world. They just will keep hitting you and hitting you. And can block off narrow areas that you have to get to. Was there a spot up here? No, there wasn't. Oh, that's right. I was supposed to hide in there.
Watch it.
Oops. That's not what I was trying to do. And that just opens up another area that you can hide in without having to be at exactly the right spot to avoid getting hit. I still hate you, personal demons. Yes, in earlier levels, I avoided breaking everything to try not to get too tall, but since I need money this time around, I am actually smashing the hell out of stuff. I can't remember where this one... up on the wall. And right there we see the first of the three kings... queens. Kings would be a different thing. That Edgar needs to complete his house of cards. But it won't be that easy.
Introducing, fresh from the Thrilla in Manila, Iowa, Tiger!
Wake up, little man. Time to go nighty-night.
I am awake.
Good. Because it is bedtime for you, snake size.
What are you talking about?
You will fight me for my card, yes?
Well, I am looking for some cards.
Then, small fry, I am afraid the Sandman is going to have to bend way over to reach you because you are so awfully itty-bitty. And then...
All right, I get it. Just shut up and let's go.
Then I will shut up, but only so I can enjoy the microscopic spectacle of your attempts to make me shut up.
So each of the cards is guarded by a random luchador. Though actually, they're not that random. If you remember, oops, I had to stop locking on. I pointed out last time that those are foreshadowed by Edgar's jacket and tattoos. I really need to stop talking. I cannot do well. Yeah, so Tiger is the easiest. It's all just about dodging him. And then smacking him when his guard is down. So once you have the wrecking ball upgrade for your levitation power, just keep bouncing into them. And also just, oops, if I had timed it right, just jumping over him there.
Avoiding the tiger pounce requires some serious tumbling skills.
And again, he steals Bobby's little dance.
Oh, sleep tight, kitty.
I always like the totally anticlimactic ending of just having them run into your levitation. Now safely back to Edgar. So El Odio also keeps dashing around here, but he has a set path. Get back here, you stupid bull, so I can show it. There. He runs around the middle area, and the one that has all of the different card shapes coming out of it is the path that he uses to get back to the streets. Once you've unlocked, once you've finished one of the lunch door missions, you can just use whichever gateway you came through to get back to wherever you were on the streets at that level, so you don't have to start over from the beginning again and make your way through the whole path. Paint! And there's these little paint footsteps. Elodia will mess up the house of cards, and you can too.
If you are curious about the load-bearing capacity of card houses, please conduct your experiments on someone else.
You can frustrate the hell out of poor Edgar.
The cards are large, yes, but it is still a house of cards. Keep off! Jumping on the house of cards, stumbling into the house of cards, driving your glowing ball through the house of cards. None of these activities help me.
Poor Edgar.
I got some cards for you, Edgar.
Perfect. One step closer to her. boy. I must have those queens.
So whenever you add a queen to his house of cards, the level that he was working on there then becomes stable. You can smash and do it all you want. The bull can run around all it wants. It's not going to knock that part down.
Jumping on the house of cards. Stumbling into the house of cards. Driving your glowing ball through the house of cards. None of these activities help me.
But the future levels are just as bad as ever. And as always, she is up there crying rose petal tears at you. That is, must be painful. Elodio the bearded bull. Hi there, crab man. Hello, crying handbag. You may weep no longer. I still find this level super pretty. Okay, let's get back to where I was. I've got the chat open in my iPad next to me, so I can see them there. Oops. I don't do the YouTube videos while I'm streaming, I just upload them later. I save the file that I'm streaming to my computer while I'm doing it, then just upload it afterwards. Though I think I'm two parts behind right now. Yeah, this part here, you need to jump and... Oops, get your aim right and then jump immediately or else he will knock you down. Yeah, but I do pay attention to the chat. I just have to keep turning my head so when I'm in parts that I have to pay attention to, I might not see something for a minute. If he goes under on a level that you're too low on, you can also have Raz stand up like that, and usually Elodia will pass right behind him without having to knock him over. Go by. Hate your personal demons. I hate you so much. Anything in this game that explodes in my face sucks. And here we have the next of the doggies painting me. Which reminds me, I didn't show how they show me. See me. Yeah, this one doesn't like me at all. He thinks that Raz is just a filthy little commoner. He will insult you constantly.
Yeah, I saw another dog selling art up the street. Are you guys a chain?
Ah, you've met my compadres. When we were young art dogs, we would run wild in the street together. But now...
Why don't you guys just make a run for it?
You couldn't understand. Elodio imprisons us all. Art is the only escape. And today is the only day that it's going to be this cheap. All these prices go up tomorrow because of tourist season.
The prices actually do change if you come back to the level again after you've beaten it. Can't remember if they were all higher, though, or not. But...
Could you tell me again?
Ah, you've met my compadre, but now...
That wasn't what I meant to hit.
Hey, can you fight bulls? I have a bull problem.
Sorry, artist here, delicate hands. And anyway, if you are talking about Elodio, well, there is, of course, only one man who could handle that much bull.
Who can do it? Who can fight Elodio?
I speak of no other than Dingo Inflagrante, the infamous matador playboy. Alas, they would never ask him to help. Not in a million years.
Why won't they ask Dingo to help? Is he expensive?
No, because what happened between him and Edgar? Quite a scandal.
What? What happened between Dingo and Edgar?
Tragedy, betrayal, art, love, pain. Nothing you want to know about.
Come on, tell me. What's the big scandal?
Listen, I deal in truth and beauty, not dirt. But maybe if you had bought some art, then I'd have to come up with some small talk while we're making change and, you know.
Yeah, so...
Gotta go.
He blackmails you into buying from him. You do actually need that one, so it's not like it's...
Now that I look at it, I'm not sure. Oh, there you are!
It's not actually that much blackmail, but... Oh, come on, get back to talking, dude.
Oh, this one's good, too. Outstanding. That's all I can say. Yes, a thing of beauty is a joy forever, but prices like these cannot last. Well, I played in the same way that Beethoven played with dissonance in the Eroica Symphony, if you follow me. I cannot look at this painting for too long, or I will cry with joy.
Yeah, the Kali is very, very full of himself about his painting abilities.
That's all I can say. Pearls before swine.
The next one that we'll meet after this is exactly the opposite.
Now then, you will of course want something else.
The Kali will go on praising himself forever. The next dog we meet will keep insulting himself forever if you keep looking at his pictures.
Ah, that's exquisitely not interesting to me.
Which reminds me...
I am a mammal, so you're close, but perhaps you should save that for someone of your own species.
Okay, I bought some art. Now give me the dirt on Dingo.
Okay, here's how I heard it. Years ago, when Edgar was a world-renowned painter, he was commissioned by Dingo to immortalize him in black velvet. But while he was sitting for the portrait, Dingo met Edgar's beautiful wife, who was none other than the top flamenco dancer, Lampito Passionado. He seduced the dancer, and the two ran off together, leaving Edgar with the unfinished painting and a broken heart. Since then, Edgar thinks of nothing but the treacherous pair, and since then, our streets have been ruled by El Odio.
Whoa, that's a great story. You should do a painting about it.
Yes, that's what we need around here. Some paintings of Dingo and bulls. Yeah, good idea.
I think that Dingo sounds like a jerk.
He gets an unfair rap because of his looks. As a collie, I know how hard it is to be resented for your beauty. It's like being forced to wear a golden robe with a diamond kick me sign on the back.
Must be tough.
Yeah, I work it out through my painting.
Gotta go.
Oh, thank God. I felt like I was being looted.
Yeah, that dog is an asshole. Again, I forgot that I didn't have my sight blast on there. I know that I could have just run then, but I am always so paranoid in this level. My first time playing this game, it took me forever and ever to get here because I kept on getting whacked into by Elodio.
Introducing, fresh from an astonishing victory at the Killings and Billings, Dragon!
You will never see that little icon for the announcer outside of this level. You will never see the announcer himself, and you will never see the picture if you don't have subtitles on. So it's nice that they made that effort to make something special for
us. What's that smell?
That smells like fear, boy!
Yeah, no, I mean that fart smell.
That's fear!
No, I'm talking about an actual smell. It's like if stink bombs laid eggs and then those went bad.
That's sulfur! It's part of the dragon costume, kid.
That dragon apparently fears the smell of farts. Special move, dude. Each of them has their own special move that they do. dragons, as you would be able to guess from this whole theme, is fire-based. Here we go. Caught by it that time because I forgot to float while I was still in the air. You notice underneath them that the queens become the ring that they actually fight on. Not just holding them captive, they are turning them into a battleground. And he just caught his other bit of special attack that you haven't seen so far. He smashed you in the face a couple of times, then light you on fire if he manages to grab you.
Soon they'll be dragging your ass out of here. Hey, are you awake? Did you hear that?
You have ever played the PlayStation version, which is the one that I've played the most times on.
I can still smell that guy.
The load times in the Steam version just seem absolutely wonderful in comparison. On the PlayStation, you will stand there loading and loading and loading and loading. I cannot speak for the Xbox version. That one I have never had anything to do with. Okay, Edgar, here
you go. Here you go, Edgar.
Perfect. One step closer to her. Please, boy, I must have those queens.
I don't have a queen. I can give you a rose.
Please, boy, no. I must have those queens.
Later on, he'll actually respond to that, but not while he is obsessed with the roses. Or not roses, obsessed with the queens. Getting closer. The rose petals are actually reaching our level here. Actually, they always do, but they're not so big down here. Where was that figment I just saw in the background? Come on, figment, I can't leave you unsucked up. I'm Coach's little figgy piggy. The fact that he is evil doesn't change that. There it is. Right next to where I was. Yeah, Crabman, they just... I mean, I loved the game. I played it on the PlayStation multiple times, but those load times would drive you nuts. This is the painting that you're supposed to use here, but there's another one you get later that you can also use there, and it unlocks, I can't remember from this one, it's a figment or a, oops, some money and stuff, but it lets you into another bit of an area. And still need to keep on smashing everything I can find, so I'll be able to use it by the last painting that I'm gonna need in here. Yeah, really, coming in here with so little money is not at all a good idea. And it is my own fault for not wanting to bore everybody watching me run around dowsing for deep arrowheads forever. That is the most awkward, scared-looking cat ever. Edgar, why is that your mental image of cats? That one's not much better. Yeah, if you nab on up here first. I hit the right button. You can lower the fire escape so it's easier to get back up onto here if you need an escape route from anywhere. And I went the wrong way down the road. No, I'm back at the stupid collie. Yeah, you can get them from underneath the water. I do. I've just been avoiding actually doing any dowsing for arrowheads while, while I've been streaming, because I don't want to bore people with me standing there with the dowsing rod out forever and ever. And I have already bought bought everything you can get at the store, so it's not like I'm... Yeah, talking to people and trying to fight at the same time doesn't work that well. I bought everything I need at the store, so I haven't had much of a reason to keep on going after them. I forgot that in this level I was going to need money until right after I actually loaded it up and suddenly remembered. If I was smart, what I could actually do there is use the painting to get back to the main hub level of this world, and then jump into the hearts painting and get back to that area. But why not just backtrack? Hup, hup, hup. That area you could just see as I was floating up there is a secret area you can get into later in the game, if I'm thinking of where I am correctly. Way up there. There's actually an achievement for getting up there, too. Here, I'm gonna get napped back. This time. Oh, really? I did not realize that these assholes could blow me up here. I guess they have the ability to climb guitars. Yeah, I can't remember if I actually have the achievement for the Secret Garden or not. I played most of this game when I was playing it through Steam offline. So I didn't get achievements while I was doing that. If you looked into my Steam account, you'd see it is really dumb looking. Like, I have the level for the achievement for beating Sasha's level a year after I got the achievement for beating this level. Yay, I made that jump this time. And then I didn't get up on time. Let's do this the quicker way this time. Jump in there, Raz. And like I said when I started this episode, I picked Black Velvetopitus, Black Velvetopia to do first because I knew that trying to talk to people and do the level, I was going to get knocked around by El Odio a lot. So better just to get that out of the way right away. And I'm just going to stand here for a second until that figment comes back. Come on, fishy, fishy, fishy. Haha. That was not what I was trying to do. Did I really just get knocked all the way back to the beginning? Almost.
What?
You know, I think even though I wanted to show off all the different dogs' reactions to it, I am going to show off how you actually use the rose instead, since I am not doing the best job on this level. There is at that spot where at that spot where I keep getting stuck trying to go back to jump onto those two poles and swing before them, you will notice there is a lady underneath one of them. And they will give you a hiding spot until El Odio goes by if you have the rose out. At least you don't lose health for this, so it's not so much resting in peace. It's just me doing a really pathetic display of this level. And I didn't time that right, but I wasn't knocked back too far, so it is okay. I might actually make it this time. Jump into the sewer, jump into the sewer, jump into the sewer. Yes! I did not fail just when I was about to give up. Yay! Yeah, that's what I was finally trying to do, Crabman. I'd have been putting off using the rose because I wanted to show all the dogs' reactions to it and Dingo's. And since I am almost out of money, didn't want to have to buy a second one to do that. But
I'm starting to feel like I'm back in high school, which is weird because I'm only 10.
But yay, now that I finally gave up on trying to do that, I immediately finally beat the stupid part. Fishy. Yeah, all the water in this level, as you can see, is red paint. Which looks more like Edgar is surrounded by seas of blood. Well, Raz is. Edgar's the one imagining it. And they vault. This vault will run away from you further than any other vault in the game because it has such a good wide path. No, not that.
Got it!
You can use invisible. I didn't realize that would work on him. Thank you. Or rather, I didn't think that even if he didn't see you, I didn't think it would help since he blocks the whole road. Yeah. So that's what those lunchadors actually looked like in real life. You can see Edgar's in the bottom right corner. Above him there is Dragon, and to his side there is Tiger. Then the other two we have not met yet. And Lana there is a cheerleader. Cheerleaders dig other cheerleaders, apparently. Poor guy. Later on, we get, another vault that lets us look at how their relationship actually begun, and it was actually kind of cute before she went and ditched him for the head cheerleader. Would be the path to the secret garden, except I do not have that figment at all right now. And now we get to play with fire! Oh, I didn't even realize you could use invisibility that way either, though I imagine they don't kiss you all over if you jump into there while invisible. So now if I fail a lot from this point onwards, it doesn't matter so much because there is a shortcut from the Collie's Path back to the sewers, which will get me to the next area I need to get at. You just need to run past a bunch of asshole monsters. I shouldn't call them monsters. For the most part, they're good things for your mental health. Other than those asshole personal demons who really are just assholes. I was wondering why they hadn't come out yet. Come on, dudes. Totally accidentally fall down the sewers while fighting those guys. This has happened to me before. And then re-trigger the ones at the bottom. It'd be a big old mess. Okay, this is not even a hard figment to get normally. Why am I unable to aim. There we go. Okay, so now we get the Divalmation. Hello.
Edgar Tegley sent me. You know, the famous painter. How about a discount?
Famous painter? Edgar? Yeah, right.
You don't give discounts or you don't think he's famous?
Look, I'm sorry, but eating lunch every day in the art teacher's room does not make you a famous painter. Anyway, you only did that to hide out from the school wrestling team.
Hey, there's no shame in hiding from wrestlers. They're trouble, especially the wild animal type.
Oh, what do you mean wild animals? Like dogs, eh? Oh, you got a problem with me now?
If you think you're a wild animal, dude, you don't know how domestication works.
No, I just meant wrestlers can be tough. I didn't mean you.
Oh, you don't think I'm tough now? Why, because I'm a Dalmatian? Hey, we can't all be St. Bernards and Bulldogs, you know.
Has Edgar always had a problem with wrestlers?
No way. In fact, he used to be the captain of his high school wrestling team. He took them all the way to the state semifinals one year, and then he choked. Cost the team the entire match.
Why did he choke? Did they get him in one of those pile driver things?
No. Edgar's girlfriend Lana Panzoni dumped him after the first period for Dean LeGrand, the head of her cheerleading squad. Tech League was worthless after that. The other team just tossed him around the rest of the day like a half sack of pork rinds. Oh man, his squad hated him after that. The whole school did.
How sad. Especially since it all happened to him again with Dingo and Lampeta.
Oh, right. Yeah, they exist. Not made up at all, those two. Sheesh. Hey, I got some original Picassos over here if you're interested, by the way.
See ya.
Yes, run. Run from the horror.
Yeah, so Edgar's internal mental figments are unreliable narrators for the most part. The further you get into the area, the more that they're actually sane seems like a mean term for it, but the more they're actually self-aware of what's actually gone on in his past. And like I said earlier on, where the Collie is completely self-absorbed about his art, the Dalmatian is completely self-deprecating.
Okay, what I was going for here was a creeping vine, the kind that grows up walls, but it just ended up looking like a truck driver's hairy back, but without the charisma. Terrible! I deserve to get my nose rubbed in this one. I can't believe I painted this. Ooh, so bad. Woof, that's all I gotta say about that. This painting reminds me of my grandpa's last year alive, just one terrible stroke on top of another. Really, I should just take this one out back and bury it. Ugh. I deserve to get my nose rubbed in this one.
I like the Dalmatian.
Look, give it up. None of them are any good. Terrible!
This one,
well, maybe you can write it off on your taxes as a loss. This ain't the Bad Art Mutual Appreciation Society. Get out of here with that awful thing.
And that one I can't afford yet, but it will eventually get me to the secret garden.
You do realize I'm a boy dog, right? I'm just asking. Don't tell anyone who painted these, okay?
Oops, so there is the next of the paintings, and my favorite of the lunch doors. Before I get in there, one thing I need to do real fast is put my shield back in my powers.
Introducing, back from a crushing victory at Someone Might Lose a Tooth in Duluth, Eagle!
That's it? Caca.
Caca. Caca.
Now keep an eye on the ground for a shadow coming up. And then...
Yeah!
but especially painful since Reyes already has the upgrade to his shield, so it's all spiky and cannot possibly be pleasant for him. I think after the first time, this dude would realize, you said, don't try that flying thing. It's especially important to wait until you see his shadow actually getting closer if you don't have the upgrade yet, because you definitely don't want to run out of your shield's timer before he actually lands. And that time I forgot that I need to hold the button for my shield. That was brilliant of me. But that's what happens when it actually hits you. I should have just pretended I was showing it off on purpose. Like I said in the first match, I love it when they defeat themselves by running into your your levitation ball. Looks so weepy, Edgar.
This one was a real pain in the butt to get.
Not really, that was the
That is exactly
one so far.
The card I need. Please, boy, I must have those queens.
Now that one really adds a good amount to the house of cards. Don't know how a single queen card adds so much structural support.
Please, boy, I must have those queens.
But yeah, at this point, you are almost to her. Honestly, if he wanted to make things easier for himself, Reyes probably could just bounce straight into her face. And just because I love the cacaws.
Delicious!
One more of them.
Need your analysis on a hostile.
What kind?
Two words. Caca.
Well, I mean, that's really one word, isn't it?
How are you spelling it?
C-A hyphen C-A-W.
Oh, well, if you're gonna use a hyphen, I mean...
It's a hyphenated word. One hyphenated word. Like, half-wit.
Look, are you...
Watch his shadow, and when you see him coming down, turn on your shield for a real back-breaking landing.
Back-hyphen-breaking. Two words.
Might as well
that
be
dragon wrestler has
here.
This roar that glues me to the floor.
That's the thing. You gotta be off the floor when that happens. As soon as he starts to let out a roar, you jump as high as you can and sigh float. Then he can't get you.
Really, if you remember that the bacon is there, it can be as good as looking up a walkthrough if you ever manage to get really stuck on this. Usually it's not isn't something you really need, but every so often you might get stuck.
That tiger wrestler's got a mean pounce.
Yeah, but it's not so mean if you shield at the right moment. And if you're invisible, then he's just out of luck.
You've been very helpful. That's all I need.
Good luck.
If I had remembered having it the first time that I ever played this game, I probably would have had a lot less trouble with the brain tank, which absolutely kicked my ass my first time through. Where are you? There you are. Oops. So at this point, you do not go back onto the road again. Well, you can go onto the road again, but it won't help you much. Instead, you go climbing.
Hey!
I didn't realize that he had already spawned. Here's another fire escape that you can knock down the ladder for as a shortcut. Or you can fall off the fire escape and miss that. And neither of the fire escapes really matter that much. They're so close to the area that you're at that they're not going to save you that much time, but it can still make things a little bit easier. Ooh, I actually never noticed that before. You spill some paint when you jump off. But anyway, but it can shave a few seconds off your time if you want. Those guys are going to run up you from over there. The window painting can be used on other hooks further back. That's when I was saying that you can use where the guitar one is. If I felt like backtracking right now, you can pull down the guitar, put up this one. Well, actually, you must be able to pull down the guitar and put back this one, because you wouldn't be able to get here without the guitar. And it will open up and give you a small extra figment, I think it is. And now I have another brain! Yay!
Got it!
That's not a ledge. Silly me. Here's the last of our dogs. And the last of our cards. I'm gonna avoid him for a minute.
You look pretty jumpy. What's the problem?
I'm supposed to paint an ad for the big fight between Bingo the Matador and the town bull. Only, the bull's on a rampage right through where the painting needs to go.
Dingo the Matador! I need to talk to him!
His apartment's right upstairs. While you're there, maybe you can convince him to take care of the bull.
If I tried to jump into that painting now, I would just completely lose. There would be no way to win because you need an upgrade that you can only get from Dingo up here. And I suppose it would be entertaining. Nope. I suppose it could be entertaining for anybody if I showed my ass getting kicked, but let's avoid that. I'm stuck! This level is also, just like the Milkman Conspiracy is the level where they put in the gate with invisibility to force you to go back to Ford and get your upgrades if you haven't been getting them, or to level up a lot if you somehow manage to get that far without reaching the rank where you get invisibility. I think it was 30. Just like that one forces you to go back for that, this one forces you to go back for the cobweb duster if you haven't gotten it yet. You can't get into a couple of the areas without it. Like, you couldn't get into the apartment back there. The entrance was blocked over with one. Hey, dude.
Ah, you must be the towel boy. You want an autograph? I don't just hand those out. And that's a good lesson for you. Anticipate disappointment. Take me. I'm the greatest bullfighter who's ever lived. Yet my upcoming match against the town bull has received virtually no marketing support. A towering advertisement was supposed to have been painted just outside my window. But as you can see, the job hasn't even been started.
I think that bull is trampling anyone who tries to paint on the wall. Maybe you could stop it.
So instead of challenging the bull before a stadium packed with screaming women, you want me to fight it on the street in front of one dog and one child wearing a crude towel boy disguise? That's a terrible idea. Here's a better one. You go get that billboard painted, and I'll reward you handsomely, which is how I do everything. As an advance, I'll give you one of my secret weapons. Use it if anyone gets stubborn.
So you can get there without hitting it yet.
You're an 8-year-old boy, so regretfully I must decline.
Oop, I wanted this. No. So for all that he calls Ray as a towel boy, he actually does see him as... I'm not sure if it's supposed to be a matador too, or at least... something. Now, one of my very favorite gags in this entire game, for all that Dingo is made out to be this great womanizer figure, if you go and jump on his bed, yeah, he gets that bed bouncing so rarely that it is full of dust. Let me out. Nope, missed that jump. Yeah, I should have even tried that one. And if you notice, the sensors get smashed by Elodio too, if you... guys. Actually, now I will fight you guys because I didn't jump there. I think I'm going to wait on that ammo upgrade, thinking about it now, because after you have beaten Elodio, he won't be running through the streets anymore. And it won't be such a big deal if you miss the jump. I always forget when I have switched out my side glass for other stuff. I need to stop doing that. As if I'd let down that ladder from the fire escape, all it would have saved me is having to run back over here to climb up. I would have been able to climb up at the other end. But that is hardly a massive time saver there. No, I'm not even bothering with you dudes. Supposed to run, dude.
Go, boy!
Forgot that I had to talk to him before doing this. Ew, will see that Elodio is waving to his many fans. This is a hint of what's to come.
It's not great, but I suppose it's just barely good enough. Come see me if you still want your reward.
You know, your advice didn't work.
Really? Then here's some new advice. I don't know what you're talking about.
How about that reward?
Fine, then. One autograph.
You know, my bulldog friend could still paint a beer gut on that poster out there.
All right, here, take this. But I warn you, I won't be able to sign it.
You get a lot of upgrades in this level. Make up for the fact that you keep getting beaten on by a bull. Actually, I should go smack something. There should still be something around up there so that I can... Oops. Get back my one missing... Come on, something, give it away. Why was that just... I can't actually jump on the knickknack shelf. Anything else I can hit? No. No. Oh well, I should be able to do it.
Next up, Junior King Kong Cobra!
Hey, Edgar. Nice headgear, freak.
What?
What? You suck, Tedley. You can't beat me. Coach says I can't be beat. Coach says I got mental toughness. You can't break my concentration, wimp.
Hey, I'm not Edgar.
Yeah? You're gonna wish you're not Edgar when I'm through.
Look, I am not Edgar Tegley. My name's Raz. I'm a psychonaut.
You're an idiot, Smegley. Coach says your psycho girl crazy lack of focus cost you states.
Seriously, I don't want to have to hurt you.
Well, since you'd have to break my concentration to even touch me, and since you can't break my concentration, I guess you won't be too disappointed then.
Yes, like I said, if you come in here before getting your confusion bombs, you're shit out of luck.
You can't hurt me at all, because the coach taught me how to concentrate on not feeling the pain. Not like you, Smegley.
As he
said. You feel everything. Like when your girlfriend, Lana, dumped you for that cheerleader guy. You felt that so bad, you blew the state semifinals. I can't feel a thing.
Yeah, you can only actually hurt him when you got him confused. But once you break his concentration, he gets smashed up like anything.
How's that feel?
Yes, and then he can do confusing on his own. Oops. So you'd think that the bombs wouldn't affect him too much when that's one of his own powers.
How about that?
Not have mapped the confusion bombs to the left side. Trying to hold
it. I beat you just like I did in high school, loser. Wait, who am I?
starts holding down the lock-on button with my left index finger and then having to reach above it to the left button was not working too well for me. But I still beat him. Just like I did in high school. Now at last, the last of the queens, and he can reach his lady love. Who is, of course, totally a delusion.
Here you go, Edgar. The last card.
Thank you. You said you would get them, and you did. Not everyone is as true to their word, you know.
Well, now you can finish your tower.
Yes. Now this can all end, once and for all.
Wow! It looks like you can walk right up there now, Edgar. Edgar? Edgar?
Going to prepare a little bit first. For the next level, you don't want your... For the next boss fight, you don't want your Psy Blasts anymore. What you want are Telekinesis and Confusion Bombs, which I'm not going to have on the left this time. Edgar has himself as king, of course.
I knew you would save me someday. He just won't let me go. Tell me, how did you kill him?
Kill who?
El Odio.
I didn't. Edgar?
He imagines his ex-girlfriend with some giant tits. Yeah, so this is... If I don't get my ass knocked down...
Elodio is a fierce, magical creature.
All about...
He can only be harmed by the traditional bullfighting weapons.
Or Diego will just save it for me.
Elodio is a fierce, magical creature. He can only be harmed by the traditional bullfighting weapons.
Got stuck right on his head there. I use the spears to attack him, and then you also can get him into the wall if he's aiming at you. Except I keep having them in the wrong position for him. Here we go. Where's the last one out of here?
Thank you for preparing the bull, my humble picador. I shall now finish this beast off easily.
Edgar, listen! There is no Elodio, no Lampita, no Dingo!
What?
You can't let the junior varsity pep squad ruin your life.
What's up with the junior?
Yeah, we were full on varsity.
Give me a G!
G!
Give me an O!
O!
Give me a B!
They stole my happiness! My life! Give me an O! The state semifinals! Everything!
Yeah, Edgar is way too old to still be this hung up on high school.
No,
but then
wait,
again, who knows how long Edgar, he's been in the asylum.
Ha ha ha. He never learns.
Oh no! I can't believe I stuck four of those barbed poles in his back.
They're called banderillas.
I gotta get those out of there and protect Edgar. If something happens to him while I'm in his mind, I'll get the boot.
So Ezra is saying there, if Edgar loses in this fight, I just in his way.
Can't get a good grip on there.
There we go. If Raz loses, then he'll get. Then he'll get booted out of Edgar's mind.
The mighty El Odio! I have all the power of the bull!
And all the weaknesses, all right.
So it's all about.
Look out! Here comes El Odio!
First, protecting Edgar by grabbing those out of him, and then using confusion bombs on Dingo so that he'll think that he's the bull.
Can't get a good grip.
Look out! Here comes El Odio!
And ideally not getting right in the way of Edgar's
El Odio doesn't like that!
And then stabbing Dingo with the...
Can't get a good grip.
Spears.
Look out! Here comes... Right in El Odio's butt!
And the roses that get tossed down around will give you a new confusion bounce and everything.
So you run out ahead of time.
Look out! Here comes El Odio!
You are not going to lose just from that.
El Odio is dying.
It's all right. It's okay. We'll win the game some other day.
Ugh, please. Edgar, look at them. They're too pathetic to hurt you anymore. Can't you just let it go?
How embarrassing. I can't believe I was hung up for so long over these losers.
I always loved you more?
It's the only point where in a non-psychic's mind they give a little demonstration of how they can control stuff inside of their own heads.
Signed, Edgar Tegley.
Finny, when you deliver this to my patronas, you may also hand him my farewell, for I am checking myself out of here. You have unchained my mind, young friend. So before I go, I'd like to show my gratitude by painting you a real work of art.
No bull?
You make light of my mental problems, and still, I have no rage. Amazing!
Yeah, Edgar is a good guy.
Now what am I supposed to do? It's not like I can reach a regular restroom when I am all chained up like this.
Yeah, he's a good guy. He just has rage issues, which you have now helped him with. And recognize some familiar faces in there.
Hey, I like it.
Ah, you see, the poor dumb beasts have no thumbs. So I ask you, how are they holding their cards?
Sticky paws?
It should be impossible. And yet somehow, they go on playing the game. In the end, Rasputin, aren't we all just dogs playing poker?
Hopefully not. I suck at poker. And I am just going to show you the after stuff in his brain.
Hey,
really
great
fast.
To see you guys all
and
together!
That'll be it for me for tonight.
Not now, Rasputin. There is a lot of money on the table.
Okay. I was just gonna hang out for a bit. Is that bull?
Long gone, my friend. The place is yours, if you'll excuse me.
Okay. Hey, great hand. Good thing we found all those queens, eh?
Ah!
You're literally rad.
Not much to do here except clean up all the cobwebs, collect all the figments, and get any vaults that are left.
Great to see you guys all together.
Not now, Rasputin. There is a lot of money on the table.
Hey, great to see you guys all together.
Not now, Rasputin. Okay. There is a lot of money on the table.
So not only is Elodio gone now, so is Dingo, and whoop. If you look up at the sky, there's just a big empty, what now looks like a flaming eyeball up there. Back to the clovers, and I'll show you at long last what you can do with the rose and those ladies. So Raz comes out of there with kiss marks all over his head. Though none on his mouth, thankfully, since he is only 10 years old.
Can't get a good grip.
And no. The art available at the various stalls changes now, and the prices of them do too now. If I hadn't gotten a rose already, I could have gotten one for free right there. That's not what I wanted either. Let me get my skills back the way I like them instead of set for a boss fight. The ladies are still as freaked out by you as they ever were. Still 75, and I think I still don't have nearly enough for it. Yeah. More free roses. Now at this point in the game, you can just get overloaded with roses. But let us go back and get that ammo upgrade that I skipped because I didn't want to keep fucking around with Elodio. So after this, I'm going to turn in for the night. I work until 4 tomorrow, so after that I'll come back for either Waterloo World or... Oh, what was Gloria's World's name? I cannot remember, but Gloria's World's. Probably Gloria. Waterloo World I like a lot, so I like saving it for last. Little teleportation dude. Run, 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 run. Make the suitcase less sad. I'll also, before I do that, dig up some more arrowheads before I start, and then I will actually show you the secret garden. Instead of staring there sadly at the picture being 75 arrowheads that I don't have. Yay! Yeah, so that can be helpful before the bullfight and before the cobra fight, but since both of them it's easy enough to get ammo during, it doesn't really matter that you don't have a slightly higher capacity. I think that Edgar would just get rid of Diego's apartment altogether. Why would he want that in his head anymore? But... Do, do. Do, 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 do. Save. Close. Yep, so I'm gonna turn in for the night. Thank you for joining me, and see you tomorrow. Bye.